Hello everyone, and once again welcome back to my channel Sarvagyan. My name is Lokendra Singh, and today we are going to discuss about very important and Linux command. The command name is vmstat. So guys, why do we use vmstat? So as you can see, there are multiple outputs of it. Like we can see like R, B, swap D, free, buffer, cache, SI, SOBI, BO. So guys, I was facing an interview with Microsoft, and this sort of questions was asked to me, that what does it mean? These two values were there, like BI and BO. What does it mean? Why do we use this sort of information? What do we get out of it, right? So if we are using this sort of information, then what does it mean? Are we really aware of all these options? How do we use it and how do we access it? So guys, before starting this description of this particular command, I would like to request you, if you are new to my channel, so please do like, share and subscribe to my channel. And if you would like me to explain any other commands, so do write in comment box. I shall be happy to assist you with that. Okay. So guys, the very first option with this command is vmstat -a. So what does it do? Obviously, it is going to print the same information like before. But what does it do? Like, it is going to provide some additional information. Like if we run only vmstat command, then it is not going to provide active and inactive this sort of information, like inactive memory, right? Initially, like we can see like process. So what is this R mean? What does this B mean? R for runnable process, which the process which have been executed and are still waiting for the action to be completed. What does B mean? B for the process which were started earlier, and right now these are uninterruptible until unless these are completed. So these are known as B. What is swap D? So it is going to show the memory status of memory. It means swap, free, I do not have swap enabled. What is total memory? What is buffer and what is cache? Now what is this swap, like swapped in and out, like how much data has been read from disk and how much data has been swapped out to disk. Then after IO, I'm going to explain it in more detail. BI, it means block input from disk and output, like how many blocks are being read, like reading and writing to of like disk. System, like inactive, like context switching. What about CPU? Like you can see over here that user, system, idle time, waiting time, and like stealth mode, right? So this sort of information we are getting. But if we type in here like vmstat -a command, let me make the font a little more bigger for you guys. So we can see here like one more field is here, like inact and active. So inactive and active memory. So guys, what does it mean? The process which are currently running and which are consuming some sort of memory, so that is known as active, right? And the process which were executed, and right now these do not exist anymore, but because there is no a new process coming into picture, no process is being executed, no process is coming up, so that is why this process, this particular memory is kept as inactive, right? So we need to understand that what does it mean. So it means the overall memory which was allocated to those process which were started earlier. For example, I executed a command cat etc, maybe password file, right? So if I executed this sort of command, and obviously this command also might have occupied some sort of memory onto this RAM, so this is known as inactive, because the command has been completed. I still have some free memory left onto this operating system. I do not need to acquire that inactive memory, right? Until unless I have free memory, so that will not be allocated to new process. Fine. What else? So guys, we can check vmstat -f. What does it mean? So guys, it is showing a number here. And what does it mean, guys? So as soon as I hit this particular command, so it is going to show like number of hops, right? For example, if I execute new command here, etc, and maybe I can type in here fstat, anything I can type in here. So guys, if I run the same command again, so it is going to add some numbers here, right? If you see here, so some numbers are added here. So what does it mean? What it is going to perform here? So guys, every time since the system booted, since the last reboot, it is going to show number of hops which are executed, which are initiated by the operating system. This is going to show number of hops. This will keep on increasing with the age of your last boot, right? So that is all about vmstat -f command. So this is going to show the particular number of hops, right? Moreover, vmstat -m. So what it is going to show? It is going to show the slabs. Now what does it mean? Slash means, like if you see here, it is going to show cache and some sort of other headers are here, like cache, XFS, DQTRX, and like different sort of information it is going to provide. It is going to provide information related to like UDP version 6, RAW version 6, ping version 6, like IPv6 fragmentation. So this sort of information is going to provide. So if you are like advanced user, then definitely you will have to read each and every component of like memory stacks. Fine, but if you see guys, again and again, this is going to show some sort of headers here. What if you would like to remove this sort of headers? What you can do here is -nm. It means only one header will be there. It will remove multiple headers from the statics. It is going to print the same information, but header will be only one, right? So let us say that if in case you are going to analyze this sort of output, so in that case there will be no need to remove the headers. Maybe you are going to take this output into any Excel sheet, then after you are going to do some filtration and all. So in that case, what is going to happen, guys? You will not be need to remove the header. So that is why we can use -n option with m. And maybe the same thing, if you are going to do it, then only one header will be there, not multiple, right? Okay, what next? So guys, we can use some other options here, like vmstat is going to be the main command, and after we can use -s here. So what does it mean? It is going to show the statics of memory utilization, total memory, what is memory used, active, inactive, free memory, buffer, cache, swap. So like swap cache, so each and everything, whatever you must be looking for in order to figure out that how your memory is being utilized. So each and every information will be printed with the help of vmstat as option here, right? Moreover, like idle CPU ticks, like IO wait, IRQ CPU ticks, like soft IRQ CPU ticks, stolen CPU ticks. So each and every information is available here, like boot time if you would like to see, well, the number of hogs. So if you see like earlier it was 14582. So right now I executed a couple of other commands in the meanwhile, and right now it is showing like this, right? Okay, what others? So guys, if you want to get the output of disk, like disk related detailed information, if you would like to figure out, so obviously vmstat is going to provide the stats of disk as well. So what is it going to do? Like the particular disk name, that is going to be total disk, like merged. Guys, what does it mean merged? Like obviously some read and write operations are required to perform a single thing. A single operation might require multiple read and write. So how many operations are clubbed in order to get the request process? So like this particular merge process is showing that. So what, like total number of sectors, how much time it is spent in order to read the data from this. So that is known as like MS, like millisecond, total writes, like it is talking total, merged, how many sectors are read, IO. So when we are talking about these operations like read and write, so the combination of read and write becomes IO. It means input output per second, right? So how many seconds it's been and all. So this sort of information is going to provide you, right? Moreover, if you would like to know about the summary of this vmstats -D, we can figure out. So it can tell you like one disk, two partition, total read, merge thread, read sector, then after milli reading, writes, and other information you can figure out in order to say that yes, you know how to use this sort of commands very, very in depth manner, right? Moreover, what we can do here is, for example, I would like to add timestamp at the end of this particular command, right? So what we can do here is, so this is the particular timestamp option which is added additionally to this particular vmstat command. So every time you are going to figure out the particular stats of memory, so you are not only going to get the particular stuff, but definitely one additional field will be added onto this command, which is going to be timestamp, right? One more thing, let us say if you would like to see the particular detailed information about it, so let me reduce it a little more. So obviously it is going to provide you memory, swap, buffer, and other sort of information it's going to provide you, right? For example, if you are not able to recall all the options, whatever I have just explained to you, right? So what we are going to do here is vmstat command we are going to execute, and after that we are going to use -h option. So it is going to print the particular stuff for help, right? So that sort of information we can figure out with the help of vmstat command. Moreover, if you are not aware of what sort of options these are, like vmstat, if I run this command, so what does it mean? Swap, D, free, buffer, SIBI, SO, and BIBO, N, CS. So this sort of information, if you do not know, so you can go for the man pages. Obviously, I know you guys are Linux champ and you know these things in advance as well. Like man command is very easy and handy as well. So we can use this particular command, and obviously like this is going to provide the information like number of runnable process, blocked writing for IO complete, this sort of stuff like swap D, buffer, cache inactive. So you can use this particular command, guys, right? So I hope this has been informative. And guys, if you are trying to know some other commands related to this particular stat and process utilization, then you can use free iostat, maybe mpstat command, psr, and top command as well. These command also can be used in order to figure out the memory information. Right, guys? So I hope this has been informative. Please start using this sort of command into your environment. Reason being, if you use this sort of command, then definitely you are going to be like in more benefit. Why it is so? Because if you understand your system very well, then definitely you will be in good position to optimize your operating system, right? So that is it for this video, guys. Thank you so very much for watching. Have a good time and happy learning. If you have any other question, do write in comment box. I'll be there to help. Thank you very much.